love y'all. Thank you so much for being patient. Sorry, I was running a little late this morning, or this evening. See, I don't even know what time it is anymore. I am super excited to open this one. So I'm taking a break from the, what is that? Oh, it's this. I'm taking a break from the Star Build Strike that we've been building. This one. I'm taking a break from that real quick because I got my nails done and look how cute they are, but they are also very long and I don't think I'll be able to do the little pieces as easily as I have been. So I was like, well, I think it's time to break this out because I've been meaning to build her for a bit now and I'm pretty sure her pieces are way bigger and way easier. It says no tools, like no cutters or anything like that, so I'm pretty interested to see how this goes. But yeah, so I put the box in the picture below too, so if anyone wanders in not knowing what we're doing, there she is! How is everyone? Jack of Spades, welcome, hello, how are you? I'm doing really good. Fantoons, what's up? Draythian, we dancing. Yes, isn't this just the best kit ever? So I got, if anyone hasn't seen my unboxing, I got this one twice because I believe, if I understand the kit correctly, you can either build it where they're separated like this, or you can just go ahead and kit bash it immediately and turn it into this. So I got two so that I could make it both as this one and then have it set up where these two can be behind it when I get another display case. So that's my plan, and hopefully one day we can take a picture and show that off, because as of right now, that's all so in the works. Oh, it's good to see you too, Jack. How are you? Thank you. I love my nails. I appreciate that. Tokens, yo. At first when I saw the Hello Kitty Gundam image, it reminded me of Samurai Pizza Cats. Oh my god. I haven't heard about that in a long time. I don't even think I watched it. I just know of it. John, welcome. All right, let's get this bad boy open, because as you can see, it's still completely sealed. I've never opened these ones. Let me know how the audio is, by the way. I was actually planning on wearing kitty ears, and I was like really excited about it because I really like wearing ears, and then I was like, no, too much weave. It's too much. I got the shirt, I got the background, I got the Hello Kitty Gundam kit. It's just, it was a little bit much. I'm like, let's tone it down in case anyone new wanders in and is just like, why? But at the same time, if they wandered in at that point, nothing. No, I could still surprise them. A few things could still surprise them. Got you on 100% volume, seems great. Should it be that high though? More weave. Okay, I'll just show y'all, do you wanna see? So I used to have a headband that looked like Hello Kitty's headband, but maybe we'll keep it on for a little bit. Yay! I don't know, man. Have you ever had like one of those accessories that just bring you so much joy, like every time you put something of that on, like be it like a bracelet or like a necklace or earrings or just something that like does that extra oomph for you? That's what cat ears do for me. Thank you for the follow, Napalm. Gundam Kitty is your embodiment. I know, it's so me, right? Mew, 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 mew. They make me really happy. I know that's a little strange, not so much to other anime fans, but it's definitely a little strange. I'll probably keep it on just for a little bit longer and I'll take them off again. I'm feeling really good. How are you, Alum? Keep it on? Okay. All right. So let's see here. We'll put this box over here. My little gate holder slash eyeshadow palette thing that I got. Pink shoes? Which pink shoes, Ludwig? Mr. Anthony, hello, how are you? Thank you for the follow, Gunny. What was I watching yesterday? I was watching, what are they talking about? Oh, okay, so the reason why it says no tools needed is because these gates, they're set up in a way where technically you could just pop the piece off and hope that it wouldn't damage the piece, but I'm still totally gonna use my cutters because that's too risky. But no, last night I was watching, what number was it? It Man 3, maybe? Or It Man 4? Well, basically it's the final one, whatever the last one is. I saw that, and yeah, there's a character that is the rank, so they just call them Gunny the entire time, and it was a really good movie. I love all the It Man movies. They're great. What is this? This is C. Ooh, these are fat pieces. Kirith, hello, how are you? It's almost 2021. It is, isn't that wild? That is. Oh, see, like one of these pieces already fell off or out. See, right here. Drift King, thank you for the follow. Oh, another one too. Two of them already fell out, so hopefully they're okay. I'm gonna have to inspect them later and make sure it came off as smoothly as I can. So this is gate A, and I'll show you what I'm doing after. Let's build! Pink Nikes. Oh, yeah. See? I feel that. I feel like everyone has that one thing that just brings them extra joy. And if you don't, then you should totally find it. And if you find it, don't be like me and like, why are there two sea gates? Don't be like me and be like somewhat embarrassed. Oh, you know what? You know how they did that? I think it's because they have it separated out. So all those three bags that I just opened have their own gates. A, B, C, D, and so on and so forth. But then this one is different. This is for the separate ones, I believe. But the ones that I opened, I do still want. It's just gonna be hard to organize them because now there's double of each kit. So when we open the instructions later, maybe it'll tell me. Maybe it will tell me to build both of them separately and then just put them together that way. That'd be interesting. Yeah, I like a lot of my thinking about this kit has just been like thinking to myself. I have no idea like how it's gonna come together. Watching Inuyasha! I was rewatching Inuyasha for a bit and then life kept happening. But I got pretty far. I'm with the Band of Seven again. Oh, see, look, this one's falling off too. But it doesn't look like the pieces are damaged, which is good. Look at this, this entire gate is a Hello Kitty head shape. How freaking cute is that? Okay, so this is special because usually with gates, they separate them by color, right? Like this one's all red. But I guess because they wanted to put this and make this super cute, they just forced as many pieces as they could onto this one and made it in different colors. I don't think I've ever seen that, but I haven't really built anything over an HG, I don't think. So maybe it's common in higher or other grades, I don't know. Capital, hello! Sorry guys if I'm missing anything, I'm like setting up and like talking at the same time. There are four It Man movies with Donnie Yen, and there's like three movies that are biopic. What's that? And a prequel. Oh, okay. Akon, welcome. It is so satisfying, isn't it, Ochiko? Ochiko. Yeah, I said that right. Business suits do that for you? Yeah, I feel like certain dresses do that, certain like other things, but I feel like the consistent one where it's like it doesn't matter what kind it is, cat ears just do that for me. They just make me happy. Yeah, isn't that neat? They did go all out for this one. I'm really excited about it. I'm kind of wishing I got the clear version too, but I had got so many in this order. I think it was part of the P Bandai exclusive, the Bluefin promotional thing, release. I had picked like certain ones that I'd wanted, and then at the end there was too many, so I had to like pick and choose. It's an SD kit, so it shouldn't be too complicated. Yeah, I don't think it's gonna be too crazy. It's just weird that they stacked two A gates. Like, these are both labeled A. And then there's two B gates, two C gates. That's a D. And then some parts came off because theoretically you could do this with no tools, but we like our work cleaner than that, so we're definitely gonna be using some stuff. Let's look at this little book. The group kits have multiple plates of the same letter. Really? That's so... I don't know, dude. That doesn't seem very helpful. Yeah, I don't think I've built any MGs. If I did, it's been a very long time. So that's why I'm pretty unfamiliar with that level. We're just building up. We started with, if anyone's new here, we started off with SDs, even though I did build a few years ago. It'd been a long time, so we start back up with SDs because I like that line that that I have. And then we just moved up to HG, right? HG? Yeah, HG. And trying to go up from there, but taking our time with it. Shishomaru is your favorite character. He like barely does anything. He is very fabulous though. I do have a soft spot for Shishomaru. I just... Rewatching it now as an adult, you're kind of like, this man is just living his best life, moving east to west, north to south, not answering to anyone, doing whatever he wants. Okay, so let's read these instructions real quick. So this talks about setting up Hello Kitty, just the Hello Kitty, with the apple. Talks about that whole setup, and then you can make her sit down or stand up. She can sit down on the apple. Let's see. And then it goes on to talking about how to build the RX-78. And then it tosses it into color on the back. So it continues. And then I guess, yeah, you just finish off the RX-78. Or if you wanted to do the combined Hello Kitty and Gundam, so it says right here, gather the parts for the combination, which is that last baggie that I had with the Hello Kitty shaped head and the bow shaped gate, and then the completed ones that you just made. And then yeah, so kit bash them from there. You just switch off the heads, add the bow and the V-fin onto the helmet, the Hello Kitty helmet portion, change a connector, and just get yourself a Hello Kitty Gundam. Okay, we can do that. So it's like what we were saying earlier, they're gonna make us build each thing separately and then bring this in, so I can move all these parts back into the box for now. I'll put the stickers in plain sight so I don't lose that either. So this can go away. This one can go away. This one with the helmet can go away for now. So we'll start with Hello Kitty. Oops, I'm trying to find a good way to fold this. The Liger, the Liger Zero, the one that, I believe they have the one that walks, pretty sure, which is the one that I remember. And it was really funny because, what's it called? It was really funny because my brother had made it when we were younger, and we found out that if you put it on a smooth surface, like a table or like a like a wood floor or something like that, it walks forward, right? But if you put it on carpet, for whatever reason, it walks backwards. So it's just like one of those neat little tidbit things that we learned. Got a badass sword at the end. Yeah, he does. I think I just got to where he got his new sword. Thank you, Mr. Popo. He does. He does have a soft spot. Haven't thought about Zoids in years. You had a bunch of them. You missed them. You can get them again. I don't know if they're exactly the same, but they should be pretty close. Okay, A, B, C, D. Okay. See, so like, for this one, we only have four gates. That's it. And then the little connector pieces. These things. Let's see. Where do we start? Oh no, I do use those other ones. Just not this one. Thank you for the follower you mode. Okay, step one is head. So yeah, if you can see how like, trying to make it focus, there it is. You can see how it's connected. You could technically just pop that off, but like I said, that's kind of risky. We like our work to be cleaner here, so we're just gonna go ahead and use our nippers like every other kit. But if you got a hold of one of these and wanted to make it with like, say your kid or something like that, because I usually like to recommend SD kits for kids, it would be so much easier for them just to, you know, try out the hobby and get into it, to build an SD like this where you don't need to worry about using the right tools or like cutting in the right place. You can just pop them out and play like the bear guys are like that too, I believe. Haven't made one in a while. Actually came off pretty good on their own almost for some of them, so yeah, they almost pop right off, honestly. Pretty cool. Oh, it's his nose! It's her nose! Oh! I was wondering why that piece was so strange. And then I have to keep double checking the piece picture just to make sure I'm cutting the right A gate. I'm pretty sure when it's darkened, like it has a darker circle. I don't know if you can see right there. When it's darkened like that, I think it means this gate. A14. Bonus all this close up to the nails. Yeah, I was like, let me build a kit that I'll be able to handle the pieces with these kinds of nails. But yes, I like that y'all can appreciate them too. Or if they're not your thing, they're not your thing, but they don't hurt to see, I don't think. Plus it's like my hubris. I tried to get, I know it's hubris. I say it hubris for fun. I got this shape because I thought it would make typing easier, and I didn't realize that like long nails are still long. It's gonna be annoying and kind of painful no matter what, honestly. Okay, how's this one go? I think it's her eyeball. Yeah, and her whiskers, see? So cute! Versus this side. So that's with the part without it. No eyeball? Eyeball! See, SDs are so immediately satisfying, guys. Like, and it's flush. Look how good that is. The nose sticks out a little bit, like it should. Thank you for the follow, Yuri. Worth all the typos. So many typos, so much backspace. Greek Tales of Hubri? What's that? A13. Thank you for the follow, Yana Bean. How are you? Welcome to the stream. Check the parts for the yellow nose and whiskers fit snugly. They do. Okay. Thank you for the follow, Yeezy. What's up? How you doing tonight? Thank you. Here, snap build ASMR. Oh, that's weird. It was at a weird angle, so I'm gonna have to clean that up. It's like one of those curved pieces. Wonder if my chisel can get it. Got it. Had no idea Gundam ASMR was a thing. Kind of intrigued now. I think we made that up pretty early on in my Gunpla streams. I used to like doing that, just holding the piece because I used to wear my headphones a lot more. So even if I snapped it like where I could see it, which is right in front of my face because I'm blind, it would make a noise in the mic. And then they said that they liked hearing that, chat did. So now I hold it up to the mic when I get a nice, good, crunchy, like tight connection that I know is gonna make that satisfying snap sound. Sycamus, can't talk, but I'll be lurking. Just wanna stop by and say hi. Oh, I super appreciate the lurk. Don't worry about it. I am so grateful you're here. I hope you're doing all right. Miss you. Let's see, what else? I like the Gunpla streams too, cause they're pretty chill. Like, we're all just vibing. Don't need to be super talkative or anything. I always wonder if anyone else is building with me. B4. Thank you for the follow, Sentai Rider Proto Bear. Proto Bear. What a mouthful. Stuck. El Hagrid, what's up? Doing good, thankfully. Hope you're good too. Yeah, I have been really good. It has been a minute. I feel like it's been a little bit. Gunpla streams make working out pretty relaxing. Is that a good thing or a bad thing? Am I killing your pre-workout jams? Or does it just make it go by nice and smoothly? Yay, that's good then. So cute. My goodness. So that's one, that's the head, and it's complete. So let's go to two. Thank you. I keep forgetting that Thursday's Thanksgiving because I'm not like really doing anything for it. But now I'm all wondering if all the food's gonna be gone from the grocery stores and stuff. Is anyone making anything or doing anything cool? I'm probably just gonna watch movies and try to see what I can put together. A3 is one of the pieces that fell off. I think it's this one. Let's make sure it's okay. Looks clean. More chill ASMR chat stream. Can y'all hear me when I'm like muttering to myself? I tried to move the mic as close to me as I can, like it's right here, but I mutter to myself a lot when I'm building. This weighs down. Oh, it's the buttons on our jumper. A2. Honestly, I keep wanting to level up and go bigger with my kits, but then I come back and snap build a these pretty well-built SDs, and I'm like, why? Why would I need to? This is so much more satisfying for me. A16. I want to level up, but this is just I get so much more done. Super cute when it's done, but at least you can see the box art. Chiha, what's up? I'm doing good, just putting this together, vibing with everyone. How are you? Apparently, these are legs. Oh, wait. Wait, if I can get it to go in. Maybe it's just secured by the back piece. But look, coming together. It's like literally, that's her leg and that's her hip. A1. Dark, thank you for the follow. Didn't they do a crossover anime short in recent years promoting this? Yeah, it looks like really weird. I love a Gundam series that plays in an anti-war stuff part, like it's really gritty and dark, but all Gundam is super deformed the models. The three-part short? Where can I watch it, Tokens? Do you know? Looking forward to get more sleep over the holidays. Same though. I was trying to figure it out. Like I keep saying, I keep forgetting that Thanksgiving's on Thursdays. So like usually I stream on Thursdays now. And I might still stream my gym, my workout, because my gym's open. And I'm probably gonna be working out. So no promises, but join the Discord and you'll get a ping if I decide to jump on stream real quick and do like a quick gym one, but I probably won't do a gaming one or anything, so I can just relax a little bit, you know, take a little time. You thought it was tomorrow? Because the days are all messed up. Thank you, Token. Unicorn Kitty? No, not quite. It's on YouTube? Okay, I'll look for it. Could never do a Black Friday shift ever again. Man, holiday shifts in retail? Crazy. I can't imagine how it's going to be during a pandemic, though. Like, I'm actually kind of nervous for how people are gonna be doing that. Like, I hope there's not gonna be too many people out, and like most things are happening online already. Because like half the stores you can't even try anything on, like you can't even use, I don't know guys, like shopping for me is like a whole thing. I have to try things on a lot of times. Things don't fit, like clothes just aren't meant for my body, so I just have to deal with weird fitting stuff and try to make it fit better later. But yeah, I don't know. I don't do like high pressure shopping like that. If it has good deals on like electronics and stuff that you scope out beforehand, that's always good. But I feel like that's what Monday is for. Yes, Cyber Monday roll now. Nothing is guaranteed, such a thin line in between. Black Friday shift at this time needs to be a holiday and hazard pay. Honestly, they need to be getting hazard pay, legitimately. I'm hoping stores have regulations or something. I think a lot of people have been a lot better, because I've been to like stores and stuff like that, and when you're in the store, people don't stay far from each other, but they don't chat. I don't know. It seems okay. Not ideal. And not, I don't know. I just really hope there aren't like crazy crowds like there always is, you know? Thank you, Bishops! I'm glad y'all talked me into putting them on. I started the stream without my ears, even though I'd originally planned to wear them. I took them off and I was like, maybe it's too much. And everyone was like, no, put them back on. And I was like, okay. They make me happy. As long as they make y'all happy too. But yeah, I hope you get to stay safe, Ludwig. Also not at Best Buy either, whereas a lot of World Star videos are made, oh god. I hope it's not that crazy this year. Oh, that's so that it can sit, see? So that's a sitting position. And then you can also, oh, maybe it's automatically in the sitting position, because that's kind of where it's wanting to be. But it looked like I could have it standing if I wanted. It's just not sliding now. Oh, I had to pull it up and out. Well, this body doesn't matter anyway, because I'm going to be building its final form, this one. I'm going to be making this one, and I'll make these some other time, the standalones. Oh. Oh no! It fell! That wasn't bad. You see how much trouble I'm having with this small piece, and it's not even as small as the other ones that we had in the RG kit. It's a struggle. We made a good call. A little stub tail. And now... Yeah, so this is where you decide if you want it sitting or standing. We'll do her sitting so she can sit on her apple when she's headless. Nice recover. I bid strength and good fortune to all those who with store slash retail jobs who may have to deal with super Karens. Do Karens have time to Karen when they're like just trying to grab and go? Like, I feel like it's gonna be less complaining unless they don't get whatever is the posted deal. A20. Karens have nothing but time. God damn. Godspeed. Two, so now we're on to three, which literally is just the arms, I guess, and popping the head on. I'll do the arms first before I put the head on, but let's clean up a little bit. A lot of nubbins. Greatly underestimate the power of the entitled middle-aged suburban lady. I told you I haven't worked retail in a very long time, and even when I did, people were pretty good. They were pretty agreeable. I worked in one of those women-only stores, basically, so... I don't know, it just seemed to maybe calm them a little bit. I don't know, I never dealt with anyone, like, drastically that I could remember that was just such a difficult customer, you know? Cat in Spanish, yes! Isn't this amazing? I don't know if you can still get this one. I think it was a P Bandai. I gotta pull it up. I'll probably try to drop the information and the link in the Discord later on. It's a double anniversary collab kit. 2019 is Gundam's 40th and Hello Kitty's 45th. I got it like... Did I get it that long ago? Huh. I don't think so. But yeah, no, I'll drop the link in the Discord later on and see if they still have it. I think just a clear one might have sold out. They might still have more of these. But there are lots of other kits you can choose from too, and help me out from ordering from Gundam Planet! !Gunpla. I don't think they have this one, but they do have a lot, and they do have like really good Black Friday sales that are either up or about to go up. I can't remember. Firehawks! Wait, what'd I miss? Oh, sorry! Oh, you said heya! Hello! I think I was, I just missed it. I'm so sorry! I'm not doing it on purpose, I promise! Retail was a nightmare. I want to buy Legos now? Why? Why specifically buy Legos? Karens are Karens because they have no sense of value to them. Just not understanding what is worth the effort or not. Yeah, like, I guess they don't choose their battles like most people do. Would be a good generalization, maybe? They just want to fight about like every little thing. I don't know. I don't know. Thank you for the follow, cat. How you doing, Firehawks? Had some personal trouble. Oh no, I hope it worked out okay. Glad to see you though. Safe. Yeah. Is it a Filipino thing, or can most people pick things up with their toes? So I was able to pick this up with my toes. I don't know if that's weird or gross or whatever, but I feel like I saw something saying that like not a lot of people or not everyone can do that or have does that, and I'm like, what? Why not? It's something some people can do. Don't know why I know that, but I do. Yeah, I feel like I've seen like memes or whatever about it. Only some people do or even want to, like maybe, like, you know, people can be weird about feet sometimes. They're just like, well, ew, no. And I'm like, it's literally just another part of your body. It's fine. Certain things. My hands are very dexterous. My feet, not at all. Mine are like pretty dexterous, I feel like. I don't know. I don't know what the average is. We Filipinos and Islanders learned that feet early on. Yeah, it's like, it's actually a thing with parents. I don't know why. Like, I think they were just always picking up their slippers with their feet to get it closer to put their feet in or whatever. Toe articulation is A1. Exactly. When your relatives pinch you with their feet. Holy shit. Okay, so that never happened to me. But I feel like I've seen it happen, like to my cousins or something like that. Like that, that's next level. There is a way to really gauge that. Is there? I can do it, but I can even move each individual toe. You can? I can move my thumb toe and my pinky toe the most, of course, but like the middle ones just kind of hang out. But that's enough. That's usually enough to do anything I might need. It's a Filipino thing! Thank you, Gamut. They make me happy. I'm glad I'm not being judged and y'all actually love it. I think it's because y'all know me. Like, you like, understand that this is just a thing. I picked up a cable with my toes. Add Cuban American to the list. Yes! You really can do so much stuff. Look, Lich, now you can do so much more things and not move. You can be extra lazy because now you have the extension of your leg, your entire leg to reach and pick something up instead of having to get up and like move your body to use your hands. You got toes now. You pick it up and you bring it to your hand and then you use your hand for whatever you're actually gonna do with it. See? Look, you learned something new. That's so cool. Majority of people I knew in Hawaii can do it to varying degrees. Helps that we went barefoot in slippers most of the time. Exactly, Draythi, and I feel like that's kind of the thing. Like, we're almost always in slippers or barefoot anyway, so we just, like, it's just a thing. Now that I have a fancy guitar pedal, I really gotta work on that toe articulation. The monkeys had it right, Firehawks. They're like, we have these extra things, let's use it. I'm like, look at all these things you can do other than just walk. Like, great powers comes great responsibility. That's for you. You're the one discovering your great powers. I've been knowing. I've been doing it. That's so funny. funny. Oh my god. What arm am I working on? Was that A8? I think I need A7 next. Yeah. 16. I got too excited. She was born into her power. Raised by it. Makers wear shoes from an early age and your feet conform to a weird shape and that limits your feet power. Is that true? I can see that being true. But I just feel like a lot of people probably just don't even try or even bother thinking about it. They don't realize this extra level of laziness they can achieve by not having to move your entire body as far to get something. I didn't even have to bend down. Y'all saw, like, I dropped the piece. It was on the floor in the carpet, and all of a sudden it was in my hand again. See? It was so good. Now a breed of toe supervillains are born! Oh my god. Is that the mold for the pieces? Is that the mold for the pieces in a Hello Kitty shape? Yeah! Isn't it cute? The gate is actually shaped like Hello Kitty's head. And then the other gate is also special. And I thought it was really cool because it's different colors. Usually in all the gates I've seen, each gate is only one color. And then the apple keeps trying to fall off, but the other gate is this one. And the other ones are normal gates, but I do think it's cool that they make it special like that. Like, here are the other normal gates for the RX-78. Oops. Oops, oops. My feet swell with joy. What is that? Well, how do you say chancletas? I just heard, do you not just say chancla? We call them chinelas. It's very similar in language because of the Spanish influence in the Philippines. Wearing shoes also limits the opportunities to even try it. what was I looking for? A19. Pop right out. I did! I saw it with my eyes and then I picked it up with my feet. Yeah, isn't it adorable? I wouldn't be able to throw those dates away. You may have had super high blood pressure. Oh, is that a Rolf quote? He actually says that? Gates, not dates. Okay, yeah. I know, I'm like, usually when I work my way through a gate, if I'm like literally halfway through it, I'll just cut it in half and get rid of the empty half so I don't have as much space taken. But no, these are freaking cute and I want to keep the box too. So I'm just probably going to keep these in the box and waste all sorts of other space, storage space for more. But I only have to keep one of these boxes because I have two of these. Ew, I'm gonna have to ASMR the other arm, that was so crunchy. Footy foots. When I pick stuff up with my feet, I always say foots be nimble. Should have just set it up this way, now that I think about it. Much better. What am I looking for? A18. I got the hiccups. Okay, ASMR. Ah, that one wasn't as crunchy as the last one, but she's got both her arms now. And then, I think I just popped the head on. Oh, and then she can hold the apple. Boop! Look how cute! Okay, let's build an apple. Did anyone get that ramen cup? Gunpla plastic model thing? The ramen plastic model? They had another one too. I kind of wanted them, but I have too much of a backlog. B2 and B3. Mr. Jim Cotta, thank you for the follow. even need new clippers. These are creating a lot of tension. Like, they're not going through very smoothly. The right arm of the welcoming one. Friend of mine built the ramen kit. Did they like it? I know it looks really straightforward, like even more so than this. But like, it's kind of cute, huh? Didn't it all, wasn't there also like a turkey or a chicken one? Like a roasted chicken? Thank you, Raph. Nice spruce. One of my favorite builds I've done was the MG Finesse. Ooh, I haven't seen that one. It sounds fancy. That amount of detail is surprising. Really, tokens? That's interesting. I'm even more so intrigued now. It's got a little roughness there. Let's try to take one of our sanding sponges to it. Where's the higher grade one? That's just the 800. Where's my 1000? Can I put it somewhere else? Oh man, sorry. I'm the only one who can see it. But that's the worst part. Here, have an apple. Look how cute! Look at this little Hello Kitty sitting in my hand. Okay guys, look. Let me show you. So cute! Look! I love her. She is adorable. Okay, now sit her in the display stand, B1. Okay. Okay, I can do that. So all that's left on this gate, the bow gate, is I believe that's the V-fin middle. We'll sit her in her stand for now while we build RX. Oh, it's legit just a flat stand. Like there's no protrusion or anything for her to like really click in. She's just totally free sitting. Okay. That's how they want it. I'll put her over here so you guys can see her. Yay! So cute. Let's clean up our nubs and move on to part two. Assemble Gundam. Time to sharpen them? Yeah, I don't know if I know how to sharpen my nippers. These are just really old too. They never made a spike in MG. Damn, just for HG. This is a Hello Kitty Gunpla, isn't it? Great knives. I like the Gundam X from Build Fighters. Knives, check it out. They even did the gates as the Hello Kitty head shape. Boop. Like that? I think it's like that. Something like that. Okay. Let's keep trucking along because I want to be able to finish this in one go. That'd be so cool. We've never done that before. This is like super easy. I know it's like Yes, it's easy because it's an SD, but SDs have taken me multiple before, and this one's like super fast. Isn't it great? I supposed to panel line this? Would it look better? I gotta look at the finished product in the box later and see how it looks. Sticker one. I think that's one of the ones that fell out. I think it's that one. A2, yeah. This one. Clean it up. Gonna need the chisel. Jackalich, how are you? Reconganista and Batista? Sticker 15. Okay, I have to take the ears off. They're irritating my glasses and my head. I'm redoing it as movies. The storyline for G-Reco is too difficult. Oof, sore. It's been a while since I got to wear those. I think it's just the placement with my glasses. Turn the part and stick this in. Okay. Now put in A3. That's a hip piece. This one's the head. One other piece got separated from the gate, and it's a hip piece. It hasn't been attached yet. I'm gonna try to watch it ASAP. ASMR. didn't click super good. There you go. You need to be forced in more than the other ones did. Let's see, 800 grit. Start applying the sticker from here. Oh wow, it even tells you like the best way to put the sticker on. That's nice. I haven't seen that before. No ASMR, there was nothing there! The Shagoon! Alright, I'll see you later. Thanks for popping in and hanging out. I hope you have a good night. A14. Ooh. Aw, man. Noelle, what's up? I'm trying to do some snap build ASMR, but sometimes the pieces, they don't want to do it. And that's okay. Keep us on our toes. How are you? Sticker 17. Okay, it said start on this corner. So I'll have to grab it on the other side. I feel like stickers are the hardest thing. Okay, do that side and then... It's actually some of the nicest stickers I've had in any kit so far though. Like, in terms of it actually fitting and them giving you help on how to put it on there. That was really good. Look at how clean that is. It's so good. I've been working a lot, so I've got the arms on and gonna do the main body and legs the next 2 days since I'm off. Yeah, no, I totally understand. It takes me several streams to do Gunpla just because I don't have as much time as I'd like and I only want to build when I'm on stream. Because I like hanging out and like using it to... I'll do other stuff off stream though, like I'll practice my panel lining and my hand painting and stuff like that. Pencil, hello, I am having a wonderful evening. How are you? Oh, thank you. I'm drinking coffee at 8 p.m. because I still have stuff to do after I finish building this. It's gonna be a long night. Okay, what we got next? Step two. C2. Thank you. Got all hyped and ready this morning. Didn't get home till 5 and start building. Yeah, that's how it goes, man. You just fit it in when you can, right? That's how I do cosplay, that's how I do Gunpla, that's how I play games. Like, everything is just fit it in when you can. But it's also fun. I'm on cup 4 of the day. 4? That's so many. If I was drinking that much coffee, I'd be like, oh, time to go on a caffeine, like, what's it called? Detox. Because it's not working anymore. Golly! Thank you so much for the biddies! What's up? How are you? Coffee's like water to me. No, water should be water to you. I'm such a big, like, water encourager. Or I try to be. Where does that go? Okay, so sticker 2 goes on that top portion. Oh, I see how it goes now. Okay. The Hello Kitty is so freaking cute. Look at this thing. Look at her. So we had to finish building both of them separately, and then we can just kitbash them together, basically, is how they have it in the instructions. Learning to draw more accurately, studying anatomy, postures, features. Oh, that's really good. Studies are hard, but so cool. I like watching one of my friends stream art on Twitch. It's so amazing to me because I can kind of like draw something, but not like really. I don't have like any creativity. I feel like that's like the hardest part. It's like coming up with everything from scratch, you know? Because yeah, it takes such a deep understanding of like anatomy and like body mechanics, just how the body like actually moves. I'm always jealous of like the cosplay girls who can like draw things, like sketch their ideas basically. And sometimes I wonder if I should do that, and then other times I feel like I'd just be like frustrating myself more than anything. Fusion Reborn, basically. Hello Kitty gonna do a Henshin. I got one for my niece, can't wait to build it with her for Christmas. Yeah, no, that's so good! I'm so glad you got one for her! Where'd you get it from? Do you know if it's still in stock? I know people were asking earlier, and I couldn't remember. That's how I was introduced to you, cosplay and anatomy searching. Anatomy searching. Gluten back day. Not today. Is that you? Is that what you're doing today? I was saying earlier, I'm probably going to end up streaming my Thanksgiving workout. It's not going to be anything special or anything, but just like, I keep forgetting that Thanksgiving's coming up real soon and I don't really have anything planned, so I'm at least going to work out, but I'm probably not going to do a game stream so I can just chill out. Enjoy my holiday a little bit. Off camera. PCC. PC. But it's like, if I'm gonna work out anyway, might as well. I don't know, are y'all gonna be like too busy on Thanksgiving? It's like, I wonder if anyone's gonna be like me and just like not really have much going on. Just chilling. I blame Retro Gaijin. Wait, how did Retro come back? Wait, did he raid me before? I can't remember. I know he's popped into the stream. Just being random, okay. Being able to draw then doing fashion design is nice, but it takes a long time to get good at it. Yeah, that's why I'm kind of like, I've done okay being able to visualize in my head so far, but I feel like I could be even better or go get more detailed and stuff like that if I could draw out more of it and kind of flesh the idea out more. But yeah, like you said, it just takes a lot of time. Can't draw to save my life, so I designed directly on the dress form. Yeah, that's kind of almost the same thing that I've been doing. It does, like, it has its drawbacks because you don't really know how something is forming in your head completely until you get it on there and you decide if you like it or not. But, you know, if it works, it works. I think it's super awesome, Athletic. I got a good friend who gets P. Bandai and Rare Kits bulk and early. Oh. Incredible simulation. For me, it'd be a nice break from editing photos, trying to get client galleries done by Thursday. What happens if it's not done though? Are you gonna work on Thursday? Can't do much this Thanksgiving because of what's going on. Yeah, no, I'm pretty sure that's most, but I don't really know for sure, you know? I'll have the stream up. That's awesome. Waking up at 3 a.m. 3 a.m.? Football? What football is going to be on at 3 a.m.? How does this go? I think it's like this. And that finish out this gate. Oops. God, I'm so bad about popping in and out of Discord. That's so funny though that you remember that, Knives. Oh, thank you for the lurk swag. I appreciate it. I hope you're doing okay. Italy, Italian football, proper football. I haven't been able to catch up with the shenanigans lately. Here you go. Nice. PCD.
Hmm.
try to post it on my Instagram, Goalie. I just haven't finished any in a bit. I remember I posted the Death Scythe when I finished that, and then we went to start the Plavsky Wing, Starbuild Strike, but we're still working on it, so I'm probably going to end up posting this one next, since this one will be the next one that's actually going to be done. It's not a dumb question at all. I'll try to come back later. I want to see the finished product. Yeah, I should be able to finish it soon-ish. Athletic. So, don't go too far. I do know Darling in the Franks, Marco. I didn't finish it. I got pretty far. That tends to happen to me. I just kind of like lose attention span sometimes. But I liked what I saw. I did a cosplay of 02, a New Year's festival rendition, a personal rendition. So not like her suit or anything like that. PCE. But I did it a while ago. Been on the same build for 9 months. Well, at least you're customizing. You have a reason. I'm just slow because I only build on stream and I only stream Gunpla once a week. And then every once in a while, I can't make it, you know? So it takes me even longer. Well, not longer than 9 months, but it takes me, like, long for no good reason. Like, it's not because I'm customizing or anything. Okay, more stickers. 13. The nails are helping. Stream needs more Gundam Epion. You need more Epion? Toggy's three more. Shared my favorite build so far was the Finis. It's the building and customizing on stream is like 1/10 of my regular build time. Yeah, exactly. So I know the feel, but it's fun to talk about while I build, so there's that. No, that's exactly how I feel too. Like, it's fun to do it with chat, you know, like, it's fun to stream it. Um, I'm not familiar with that one, Marco. Thank you for the follow. I always get told to cut my nails, but I'm like, I can grab the tiny parts better. But mine are at that bad point where they're too long and the tiny parts get lost in them. There's a fine line. They tell you to cut your nails? Never! Or rather, not right now. Your body, your choice. Oh. This part fall out. There, that's why I didn't snap it in. Okay, what else is there? Two more stickers, 19 and 18. Here? Kind of weird. That's too specific. Oh, 1000 minus 7. I thought you were saying like a number, 1000-7. Yeah, no, I remember Tokyo Ghoul. I just haven't thought about it in a pretty long time. It's an older one. How old is that now? Got a Zoom cam for build streams, and suddenly everyone's a cuticle critique. Oh my god, cuticle critic. Damn. You're like, pay for my manicures then. Jeez. That's awesome. You got to level up your stream though. Thank you. Is that all the stickers? Yep, now D4. Nice, nice. Okay. Now clean up, then flip the page. There's just a few more stickers, but it seems like that's gonna go elsewhere. Now they give us color instructions. Sonic, thank you for the follow. Trying to figure out what I'm doing to this piece. Okay. I'm so close to getting my splits down, you guys. I went to the class for the first time last week, and I couldn't get into this week because it filled up so fast. But I got so close, and I was so proud. I'll have to post a picture in the fitness channel or something like that if I can. But yeah, I've been practicing my splits, like, even on stream, like, after after working out sometimes if I have extra time. And it's a lot better. I don't know what she did to open my hips up, but they are a lot more compliant to the motion. So I'm super excited. Never made a Gunpla, but it's fun to watch them being made. You should try it. SD kits are super simple. They don't all look as funny as a Hello Kitty one, but they're super simple. They're like a lot less intimidating than you might think. And they're made really well now. Like, they look really good versus, like, before how SD kits used to look. They look like really shitty. They did their best, I'm sure, but they definitely weren't as cute as they are now. I appreciate you hanging out. Flex! Yes! Gains! Getting them flexibility gains. Small progress to the bigger goal. Keep it up. Yeah, no, exactly. I've been trying to get my splits down for years now. Not as consistently as I should have been, probably. And that's usually the biggest issue if you're not seeing progress because you're not consistent. But even when I did do it consistently, I would have, like, not any progress at all. So I was like, well, I already know I'm not doing it right, so hopefully this class will help me, and it totally did. Like, helped me so much. It was so cool. Still very, very painful. Very painful. My hips have always been my problem area too. Like, people always worry about their knees when they're squatting. When I was squatting heavy, my biggest issue was always my hips. I had to spend a lot of time opening my hips up, making sure that they were, like, warmed up and ready to go for the heavy lifts. So I don't know if maybe that's also a thing of why splits have always been difficult for me, but I'm a lot closer than I used to be, and that's all I want. Just like you said, like, little progress points here and there. For martial arts, what, your hips? I noticed my hips for the first time in martial arts. I didn't do very much, but I definitely knew immediately that my right hip was gonna be my problem hip. And, like, even now it's a little sore, so I just gotta, like, work out some parts. I've never used, like, a Theragun and stuff. Does anyone here have experience with that? Like, is it worth it? Before when I was powerlifting, I would do a lacrosse ball. I would just put it in my hip and, like, lay on my front and just kind of roll it in there. I lost my lacrosse ball, so I haven't done that in a bit. I gotta get another one. I was developing this popping noise in my hip because of it. Yeah, no, my hips pop. You own a Theragun? What do you think? Do you use it enough to justify the cost, and does it help you enough to justify trying to make time to use it frequently? Definitely worth it as an idea, but the cheap ones work just as good. The cheap ones are just, like, louder, right? I feel like that's probably a lot of what's built into it, is, like, built into the price of, like, the more expensive, like, brand name one, is that it's, like, quieter, but it's, like, you don't use them forever, right? Okay, that's what I thought. It's, like, it's quieter and maybe, like, easier on the hand, like, less shaking, I guess, is what I would think. Because I've used my friends at the gym and stuff like that, like, way long time ago, and I think the gym has one even that you can just, like, ask to borrow, but I don't even know how to correctly use it, so I've never really done it. I have a cheap one. It really helps. You feel like it really helps? That's good. Huh, I'm gonna have to get that, the link from you. Or see, you know, what, did you get it a while ago, or is it recently? At my running store, we sold the $500 one, and they're cool, and I bought a cheap one to compare, and it's the same shit, really? Like, exactly the same? Or did it have, like, those little comfort things, like, the handle didn't jiggle as much, and it was quieter, and, you know, like, the slight luxury of it, which doesn't justify the price to me, like, for it to be, like, double or triple the cost, but it's just good to know, like, that's what's built into it, you know? Or was it literally exactly the same? I unscrew them apart, and motors are very similar. Yeah, I think the function, the motor is gonna look the same, but it's, like, the extra things that they put in there. A9. It helped my back and hips, and helps get blood into the area. Oh, so you use it pre-workout as well? I didn't know that. I think I've only... No, you're right. My powerlifting friends used to do it just whenever. I thought they were just fucking around. I didn't think it was for a reason. I thought they just wanted to show off their thing. It literally hammer drill repurposed. Exactly! That's all, like, it's... I think some people even do that. Like, they literally just try to make their own, and it works the same, but it's, like... It's less luxury, you know? 95% the same. The plastic around it is different than the tips. The gun itself gives it shape in gold. Everything is the only difference. Yeah, it's just the paint job. Hold everything and hold everything is... The gun itself gives it shape and hold. Everything is the only difference. Hold everything. You lost me. I thought you meant the paint job, like they made it gold and like now it's $500 instead of $200. Thank you for the follow, CD Wolfie. A9. Different looks cosmetically, yeah. And hold everything is the difference. Oh, okay, I see. It's so funny you took them apart just to see. How much was the one that you got, Ludwig? And then how much was the one that you got, Draythian? Just to see what the range is. You just have an extra one, Ludwig? Yeah, I do. It's the same thing. It's the same one that's on my Instagram and my link tree. It's all in there. All right, well, have fun editing, Delphine. Delphine or Delphine? I'm pretty sure it's Delphine. Yeah, no, thank you for hanging out. Have a happy Thanksgiving. And yeah, I might jump onto a fitness stream on Thanksgiving if you're too busy, you know. I will be around. You can catch up on the Discord too. I don't know if you're in it already, but if anyone here isn't in the Discord, they're usually the ones that'll get the most up-to-date information on streaming. Shinonimi, thank you for the follow. $60 off Wish? Dang, that's a gamble. I don't know if I trust... Wish has been pretty good. It just does take a long time. But I never... Delphin, not that Spanish. Gotta keep my eyeliner. Got it. But I don't know if I would trust Wish for like... electronics, I guess? But that's really interesting that it actually ended up being the same. Draythian, mine was 65 from Woot. What is Woot? I haven't even heard of that one. Thank you, Tokens. If I didn't join her Discord, she used her biceps to break my arm? Slander. These biceps are just for good hugs. Or whatever, I don't know. We don't hug anymore, this COVID times. See, you can't even see them in this lighting. Impromptu flex show, what? This lighting blows it out too much. You don't get anything there. I don't even look like I lift, bro. Was that anyone any better? Wait, where's the camera? Okay, here. You can kind of see, you can see the tricep more than the bicep. My triceps have always been really, like, distinct, though, I feel like. Amazon is a clearance site? I was not aware. Yeah, I know, it's because everything ships from overseas. I just didn't know if they, like, I guess I should just follow my usual rule of like paying attention to the reviews, you know? Thank you for the follow, Benny Chan. Social distance hug flex. Don't be fooled, she's strong. I promise I'm like kind of strong for a girl. I see them. That's good. Free gun show, guys. Be blessed, right? Because we got such a nice little chat here. It's not blowing up like crazy or nothing. Plus, I always wondered, like, this is why when I do the gun shows, this is why I go all around the entire freaking gym trying to find the right lighting, because there is bad lighting. Like, I feel like this totally takes away, and I have no pump or whatever, which is also why I don't do gun show during, like, these kinds of streams, like, not gym streams, because, like, I swear, a pump makes such a difference. I'm sure Amazon has cheap one too, since they're independent sellers. Usually use Woot for shirts. Oh, really? A lot of small businesses come out of there too. Hmm. She crushed the watermelon with her thighs. Oh, yeah. That. I feel like that's such a strange measure of strength, but it's more relatable for whatever reason than just my lifting numbers. It's on the IGTV. So, like, you know how when you go to my profile, like, they have the different tabs for, like, it's gotten so complicated now. But if you go to my profile, there should be, like, one that's basically all my posts, and then there should be IGTV, and I think if I had Reels, it would have one for Reels, and it has, like, one post that I've been tagged in. So if you go to the IGTV one, you'll find it a lot faster than trying to go through all of my posts and find it. But yeah, so if you want to, it's gonna be way easier to find there. Watermelon! What's up, Mana? How are you? Let me know if you find it, Knives. If not, I'll have to put it in the Discord. I'm saying all these things and not taking any notes on what I have to do later. I'm gonna forget. I always do. D3. That's why I have to write down notes. Oh, we're already giving him a little fist. So soon? I say soon, but I've been building this for over 2 hours now. Still much faster than if I were building anything else. See how much easier that is? But yeah, it's weird that it has all those sections. I haven't even done, and it's very long. I think if you skip to, like, I think I put in the caption what number you need to skip to. It's very, like, if you just want to see, like, it actually happen. Because I like showing, like, how hard it was. It wasn't, like, because I've gone over this before, but, like, a lot of people are like, aren't the bigger ones easier? I was like, I really honestly don't think so. So I wanted to show how hard it was, and that even, like, my friend tried and he couldn't get it either. And he's also, like, a bodybuilder guy who couldn't get it. So clearly it's not super easy, you know? I don't do contact. Which grade is this? This is an SD. This is crazy for an SD, is it? See, I don't know. Like, I guess, yeah, it does have quite a bit going on, huh? It's an SDEX. Oh, does that make a difference? Yeah, it says in the picture below, that's the box art, so the SDEX standard. Don't know. Thanks, guys, reading is essential. It's okay, there's a lot going on the screen, I totally understand. At one point, I need to give it a try. You should! I feel like it's just one of those things that you just want to see if you can do. And honestly, I'm still playing with it, but I want to find a way to see if it's possible for me to stream doing smaller ones as like a big goal type thing. Like if I can do like the smaller watermelons, but then like summer was over, I had a lot going on and all my plants fell apart, but it's okay. We have them for next year. I'm good, just getting it in. How are you? Good day? Yeah, I had a pretty good day. Couldn't focus on anything. Thank you. You're sweet. I'm embarrassed. I probably could, but that's the thing. I just like, it's got more setup to it. I wanted to get like the smaller watermelons to see for myself if it's easier to do a smaller one or a bigger one. Because that watermelon was literally the size of my torso. Like, if you watch the video, it's like this big and like this wide. Like, I'm not even exaggerating. It was a Texas super-sized watermelon. So, and it had a very thick rind. Like, it wasn't like all hollow or anything like that. You're tiny. I'm not like super tiny, but yeah, I'm not like a big person or anything like that. Exclamation point stats. It's like the size of a kid. I know, I crushed a whole tiny human size. Yeah, it's like, it was pretty sizable. Like, I tried to show just how crazy it was, but yeah, so there you go. Now you have like a better perspective, because I know like camera perspective is very different from like real life. So I like that I can put my measurements there and you can kind of get a closer feel for like what I actually am like. Because people are like, oh, I thought you were taller, which is really funny to me because I feel like I have very short proportions, but people think I'm taller. I have short legs, it's short little short Asian femurs. A6. Tokens, what's the difference between a SD and an SDEX? Is the EX just like extra? It's just like extra cool? Pretty average height, yeah. I'm like kinda tall for a Filipina though. Cause I think their average is like 5'2 or something. You putting all that up, I have a pretty good idea. Yeah. I can post a link to stuff. Okay, just don't post a link in chat. You have to do it in Discord because my bot will time you out if you do a link in chat. One of my friends is 4'11". Yeah, no, there are people who are shorter, but for some reason, I'd heard a lot that people thought I was taller than 5'4". Slightly more detailed and proportioned. Oh, well, are there more? I really haven't seen that many that say SDEX. I thought you were taller. See? when we go to a restaurant, they always bring her crayons and a coloring sheet. I think I also had a friend in high school who was 4'11 or so. And I think in driving school, they made fun of her because I think legally she's supposed to be in a car seat or a booster seat. It's a new line of SD kits. There are a few. Oh, that's interesting. Good to know. I want to look for some. Because, like, honestly, the Chinese mythological or, like, you know, that SD line that I have been building off of a lot, it's really detailed. So I was surprised that there's technically a grade up from that. A half step up. Not new, but newer. Okay, I see. Post it in Discord, you can search for stuff and you'll find it usually in shirt size wise. Okay, awesome, thank you. I will check that out. A8. Double checking myself. Sizes are weird though, might end up needing a men's medium. Yeah, no, I'm totally good at being wary about that. As long as they have like a review section, I can usually just read the reviews and kind of see what other people are saying is like typically how I go about it, and that usually works out. Like if they say that it runs small, size up, or if it runs big, or you know, true to size, all that good stuff. Yeah, we're doing Gundam, Alucard! Exclamation point Gunpla! Yeah, thank you, Kishan. Thanks for the follow, Crazy Asian. Crazy Asian. Oh, I hate these, I don't know what they are, like ankle covers on Gunpla. They don't always stay where they're supposed to, and they can be kind of annoying. Ooh. I cut it, and it split off the piece, because I cut it over here, and it jumped into my trash box that I've been using to keep the nubs. That's so funny. Why? Well, so extra, he ejected himself. Told y'all my parts be flying everywhere. Or my nubs. Okay, that's actually super secure compared to some of the other ones I've had to build. Thank you for the follow, Pro Productions, Pro One. The ankle armor can be really finicky. Yeah, it showed itself out, it honestly did. No, I think it was, I think even in the death site that I built, it was like really not secure. It pops off every time I move him, and so it's just kind of freewheeling. But this one snapped in really, really good. I think they're onto something with these SDEXs. Yeah, I can get behind this. I gotta look for more. I gotta see who carries them. Or what kits they come in. Cause this is... The fact that I think I can finish this in one stream is like, exciting to me. Hiccups. See, that's the problem sometimes with chisels. You can go too deep. If you're at a bad angle instead of flush with the part. Just riding around in a Gundam? Ugh, what a dream. But could you imagine, like, gas? Wait, what's a Gundam run off of? Someone who watches it, tell me. Y'all know I don't have all the backstory. I just like to do what I like to do. 20. I just like to build them. They're so cute. What powers the Gundam? Can't be gas, can it? Compact reactors? Depends on the universe. Universal Century Timeline, they're fusion-powered compact reactors inside them, and if the reactor takes a direct hit, it explodes like little nukes. Hell yeah, little nukes. Oh, Neon says they're run by male virgin blood. Sometimes in the OG timeline, the souls of dead people make a good substitute. What? That's just like, you're fighting a war. There are so many dead souls. That's so weird. That is wild. What the hell? What a loaded question. Who knew? Well, tokens new. Okay, I swear we're almost done. We're getting real close here. We got the two arms, we got one leg, we need one more leg, we need the skirt, hip thing, put it all together, give it its shield, weapons, and then trade off the heads. And give Hello Kitty its Gundam helmet. Almost done. Not bad for as distracted as I get, as easily distracted. A 13. Ugh. What a bad way to connect them. Oops. Recycling, it's environmentally friendly. Holy shit. I can explain that, but it gets a little out there. Gundam is a crazy time, clearly. My god. If you're not too busy, I wouldn't mind it, tokens. I know you said you're multitasking, you don't have to. I need to make a PowerPoint. What? You gonna share your screen? Do a whole little presentation? So funny. Flew off again. But didn't go in the box. Just making a mess. First slide is just a flowchart. The next five slides are the continuation of the same flowchart. The fact that you understand the OG timeline is impressive. Getting mad ups. Tokens knows so much about Gundam. And Gunpla. See, listen how good this ankle portion clicks in. Oh, I swear to God, every time I try to make y'all listen to the second piece, because the first piece was so good, it doesn't do the thing for you. Thank you for the follow, Boba T and me. What a name. Welcome, welcome. Love it. Now you're going to get us talking about Boba T, and everyone's going to want Boba T. Happens every time. We're a hungry group here. Let's see. Oh, that's the last one of these dealies. Yep, no more on this gate, so into the box. B. Oh my god, you know what I should do before it's too late? We should have another terrible Twitch Sings stream. Wait, is it still going away or did they fix whatever was the issue? Oh damn, here we go. Is this a difficult build? No, it's not. It's pretty easy. It's just a little more involved than your usual SD. But SDs in general are very easy to do. It's the dancing frog. It only does it for you. What dancing frog? Basically, in the UC timeline, most of the excess of Earth's population is moved out into space. Part of the political plot, I'll explain that part as needed. And over time, the people in space start evolving and getting, well, basically psychic abilities. Nothing too fancy, just telepathy stuff. And being able to instantly understand someone. Another major plot point and the purpose of this. They are considered a new type. Oh, okay, okay. Of humans, so they're called new types when regular people start. Book, 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 book. Oh no, new types are being explained. Yeah, see, the whole thing that turns me off of Gundam is the whole political plot. I get, like, that's a thing, but I don't watch anime for politics. It's like walls of text or just, like, episodes of talking. Discovering the existence of new types, the first thing they do is use them as weapons. They start making machines that can utilize their abilities and adding these devices to mobile suits and mobile armor, bigger mobile suits. Just telepathy stuff. So remember in Looney Tunes, Porky Pig saw a frog that would dance and sing when he brought it to someone, it just lay dead? No, I don't remember that, Knives. The piece that wouldn't do the thing you're having issues with is your dancing frog. I don't remember Looney Tunes that in depth, but that sounds right. That's awesome. What a reference. Gundam Unicorn does a very good job of melding politics and super sincere operatic emotions. Really? I think, whenever I can set it up and figure out when's the best time I can make it work, I think, like, we wanted to do Gundam Nights, where, like, I stream in Discord watching it, since I'm terribly new at everything. But they voted on something else. I keep forgetting which one it was. Everyone that was there when I had asked decided to start a certain one. Or decided it was a good place to start. That's the main reason I don't watch any Gundam, because it usually boils down to politics. The Gundams themselves are pretty sick, though. Yeah, that's how I feel. I know everyone doesn't really think great of it, but the one I probably saw the most of was Seed. I did see some of the ones that was shown on Toonami, but not enough to really remember it. Seed was the one I really liked a lot because I like the Lacus. I like Lacus a lot. The rest of the technology just gets more and more advanced in how we have a device and cycle frame created to let new type pilots control parts of their machines through thought, because as new types they have mental horsepower to handle it. I like the way you describe it. I don't know why, but the politics in Gundam makes it more serious. I kind of like it because it makes it serious. No, that's my problem with it. I don't want serious anime. Yeah, no, Seed is good. oh man, give me a pink haired waifu songstress princess thing with a great wardrobe and I'm in. Thank you for the follow, Temba. Alright, let me try to get this problem sticker on. Oh, much better this time. Much faster. I remember Gundam Dice the most. I don't know if that counts as real Gundam though, since it was literally 3D talking Gundams. Are you talking about that, what was that one? It was the SDs. They were all SDs. But the Psycho Friend could do more than that. Long story short, they didn't really know what all it could do. It basically can also take human will and convert it into power living. Convert it into power, living and dead. And recently in Gundam, they said it's also capable of time manipulation. And for all this crazy stuff to happen, a new type has to be behind the wheel. Huh, new types are a lot more OP than I thought, I guess. Because I think I only remember what you were saying, like they just kind of like, in the beginning, just kind of like understand things better and they're like characterized as like a higher class. No, I haven't watched Macross. He's sweating. He typed out a lot. Gundam 00, get ready for aliens. Isn't the whole thing about aliens? Because they're not even like aliens, they're just like humans that... Am I getting it mixed up with, okay, probably the one I liked a lot, it's not Gundam though, but it's, Mecha. It's Mecha, right? See, now I can't even remember it clearly. Nadesco? I like Nadesco a lot. I haven't watched it in a while. I have the box set though, I need to watch it. The mini ones. Yeah, which one had the Shining Finger G Gundam? New types are broken. The movie has aliens as protagonists. Yes, Nadesco! It's so good, right? Ugh, the Techno Fairy? That was my shit. That was like, I wanted to be... What's her name? Was it Yuri? I wanted to be Yuri so bad. There's just something about her that was so badass. The movie has aliens as protagonists. Cyber new types are broken. No, it's not. Yeah, that's what I was saying, that is that it's a mecha. It's not Gundam, but it's mecha, and that's like probably the only one that has like somewhat plot that I got all the way through, just because it still wasn't as heavy as Gundam is, but it still had more, it had a good, just I think the right amount of plot, honestly. Biggest new type weakness is their overactive empathy. Oh, they're just sensitive. Thank you for the follow, Streaming Empire. They feel too deeply. Is that my superpower? It doesn't give me any good, though. Oh my god. Oh no, we're at a point where the nubs are covering the instructions we need. But I'm not at a point yet where it's let me stop and clean up. I think that's this part that fell off. Let's make sure it's clean. Oh, Ruri! Yeah. Ruri. Ruri's the one. I'm trying to think of a mech anime that doesn't have a large political plot. Yeah, I don't think there's that many. Macross Plus. Okay. Is it on anything? Is it streaming on anything? Yeah. It's hard keeping all that in my head to type out. You did great, Tokens. Thank you, but that's a short version of it. That's a good version. That was nice and concise and understandable. Gurren Lagann, yeah, so I watched a little bit of that, but not all of it. Star Driver sounds very familiar. Star Driver. It's not bringing any images to mind. Gurren Lagann is super good. Okay, that's what I think a lot of people have told me. I just haven't gone through it. I don't know why. I like stop paying attention after a little bit for a lot of stuff. I think it's because I don't give myself time to really sit down and watch an anime, so it's like really helpful if it's dubbed, even though I prefer sub. But if I'm not paying attention to sub, then I'm not watching it at all, so I might as well somewhat watch a dub. Mira loves it, she has a hard time watching Mecha too. Okay, well that's good to know. Gurren Lagann is great for enjoying. Macross Plus is on YouTube, okay. What is it about dark and serious anime that you don't like? It's not the dark and serious, I guess it's the darkness isn't a problem, it's the serious talking that I'm like, okay, like Gundam is like such a good example of just too much going on. I can't remember these, imagine like these fake countries with these fake issues and these like, you know, like I can barely keep up with what's happening in our real world sometimes. Without, and like, watching an anime, I feel like I have to make, like, what y'all said, like, a flowchart or, like, a family tree thing. Thank you for the follow, Jakai. Still trying to get her to finish one. Gundam can be too plot-heavy, so it turns a lot of people away. That's what I mean, you know? Like, it's just, it's not too dark for me or anything like that. I like dark animes and, like, weird stuff. But it's the... If you were reading it as a manga, it would be pages and pages of text. And that's boring to me and hard to follow, you know? Who don't want to follow a fake world events? Let me take this world's problems and make them understandable and my own so I can feel what the issues that these people are facing and how war is complicated and not everything's black and white and everyone's just fighting for their belief of good and justice, you know, like like it's too real world for me. I watch anime to like get away, you know, or like to enjoy or to adventure. I don't watch anime to like feel the feels of real world issues just in anime form. Gurren Lagann is one of the few shows that made me legit cheer when shit happened in the series. You had to be born in that world to fully grasp the situation. That's what I'm saying. This guy's a dick, so I'm a punch. Exposition can be the biggest turnoff for a series. I'm still trying to get into Gundam Wing. Yeah, I hope that does make it more understandable to why I'm like just not totally into Gundam the series. 60-70% of the series is exposition. Gundam started this subgenre in Mecha, the real robot genre. Thank you for the follow, Salem. If that's the case, I can recommend watching Heavy Object. What is that? I've never heard of that one. And what's it on? What's up, citizen? Anime can go really hard with that vibe too, where some creators know how to push that existential button. Satoshi Kon does it in such a good way though. Like, Satoshi Kon is a true storyteller, I feel like. He has this way of getting you into his weird, but still relatable world, and not having to, you know, what we're saying, exposition, not have to break down every minute detail of why this world is the way it is. It just is, you know? Like, I feel like that's the property of a good storyteller, is to just throw you into this world and you get it. You understand without having to be told how to understand, you know? Yes, please do, Ludwig. Thank you. It's the movie and not the OVA for Macross Plus on YouTube? Okay. Yeah, Firehawks is basically like what- ah! Holy shit, I'm sorry guys, I hope that didn't hurt anyone's ears. Oh my god, I haven't seen that in a very long time. Thank you for the bitties, Boba Tea. Yuck. Oh my god. Yeah, Firehawk's basically what I was saying. It's that it has to explain everything about the world. Exposition just means they really have to break every step down, and it's like, ugh, how much of this do I need, and how much of this is just you trying to show me how much you've flushed out about this world, you know? What Khan did with Paprika was masterful in introducing the world and how it works. Exactly! That's what I'm saying. Like, it was. You got it. You got a little bit of explanation and everything else fell into place, you know? I really liked Millennium Actress is one of my favorite movies. Favorite. You just. Ugh. There's no explanation either. It just is. Like, not a real explanation for why what's happening is happening, but you fully accept it and you're immersed in the story. My pants! Yeah, Naruto can do it. World building stuff can sometimes feel like a rabbit hole for its own sake. Yeah, exactly. That's what I mean. It's like you're just showing off at this point that you delve this deep into this story plot line that honestly does not, it's not required for the part we care about. And that's when you get too much into why am I reading this page of text that has nothing to do with a plot. And sometimes it can be done in a way where yes, it does come back. But usually when you're having to explain it in that way, like with exposition and everything, it's just even if it comes back, you have to be paying really, really close attention to realize it. And it's, I don't know. I think y'all get what I'm saying. That's the problem I have with a lot of mech anime and political animes, is like they just go too hard on the small details that I don't care about about their world. Like, I'm sorry, I don't care about, but I'm sure you could show this to me in a way where I would understand it without needing it told to me. Okay, let's keep going on this. We're almost done. Nine. Mr. Panda, thank you for the follow. Mora, thank you for the follow. If you have any more questions about gun and stuff, feel free to ask me whenever. I'll answer best I can. I believe in tokens. Thank you so much. I super appreciate you going through the time to do all that and explain it all. It's such a fun way too. I like you really were. You think it's a lot, but it was like very concise the way you did it. Now, if only Gundam could be like that. Someone make a concise Gundam and I'll watch that in a heartbeat. Did I mess up? Is this on the wrong part? It looks so right. Oh shit. Okay, well, technically I messed up, but also technically I was supposed to do that anyway. Hopefully. Oh no, they're different size. I put the wrong stickers on the wrong part! Cause I was. Okay, let's see what we can do. Alright, let's try this again. A10. Ah, man, I thought A10 was the part that had fallen off because it looks just like it. But it was not, and I was moving too fast and didn't bother to check. Silly! Hopefully, we can fix this. It should be fine. Oops. With shows that have too much exposition, I'm like, if you want to write a book, write a book. This is visual medium show. Oh my god! Bulma! thank you again, Jesus. Yeah, that's what I mean, Draythian. I just like, show me, you know? Just watch a Gundam OVA series. They're often short and to the point. Build Fighters is pretty concise. I did like Build Fighters. Straight to the point, no political plotline. Very true. And lots of fun Gunpla. Fingers crossed you can fix it. I know. I'm so bad. Final Fantasy 15 was like that too. Now we're talking about this, I'm just now realizing. Did you ever think, like, when you were playing something that was like that, that you were just like, come on, like, get over it? So you know, like, you understand what I'm saying about, like, it's just... sometimes it's not worth it. I hope I can fix it. I thought maybe they were the same size stickers and they're not, which makes it that much more difficult to figure out if I can fix. Yeah, this is super detailed. It's like really cool. I'll show you guys here in a sec what I'm doing. The way that they did the sticker and the way they did the piece is already beveled on the inside. And the sticker was made to fit perfectly on top to bring the depth. Ooh, come on, pick it up. Pick it up. There you are. You see how, does it look raised to y'all? That yellow part is actually raised. Which is really cool. Thank you for the follow, Andy. We're a month late with the scares. But they're whatever. Shouldn't always have to sway everyone away. Yeah, no, it shouldn't. But some people, like me, will be swayed away. Not everyone, though. Well, it was nice stopping. I have to get ready for work. Oh, well, have a good day at work, Pencil. Thank you so much for hanging out. I'll see you later. Custom Misha notifications would be dope. Aren't those custom? Those notifications are custom. That's the artwork that I had commissioned. But yeah, I was thinking of changing some of them. Sorry guys, my head's itching. I was thinking of changing some of them to like gifts and stuff at some point, but I like them. Ooh, the detail's crazy, right? For an SD? That's wild. Okay, let me see if I can fix this now, because this part that I just did is what needs the stickers that I just put on here for this. So this is supposed to look like that. But I put its stickers on the wrong one, and I thought maybe it's interchangeable with these stickers that are the same, but these stickers are smaller. So this one needs the bigger stickers. And I thought that maybe these stickers were a little big for this part, but I just kind of went with it. I should have realized that, like, this kit is very deliberate in how they're doing everything because it's so well detailed. I don't even know if I can get this off. Let me use my stronger tweezers. So like these ones are really good because they're like very flexible and they come to such a good point. But these ones are a lot stronger just for gripping. I just don't want to rip the piece or the sticker. Because it has cutouts to help it fit around the detailing, but that means more rip points. Ugh, see, I ripped it. Fuck. Ah, damn it. Well, good thing I have two. Alright, I'm just gonna keep these on here and force the other ones on the other one. That sucks. I suck. It's okay, I'll probably switch it off to where this one will eventually be the standalone and not the main big one. Only y'all will know I made a mistake. secret. See, this one actually fits fine. Not perfect. See? It's actually not terrible. But I think you can tell on this one that the stickers are too big, but maybe not. You know? I'm telling everyone! Yeah, it has those cuts. Blow dryer, no, I feel like I would do more damage than help to warm it up like that. Erase for extra detail makes it easier to paint for those who like to paint. Yeah, no, I usually love to paint, but I want to do it the way they want me to, and then maybe later. Yeah, peeling it with a knife would have been risky. More paint, it's been a battle. How many Gunpla do I have? A lot. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 19. This would be 20 for what I can see. And then I probably have 30 at least in my backlog. And yeah, a lot. It's so easy to collect a backlog though. I feel like it's like, it just happens naturally. But I started streaming Gunpla building to get through my backlog, and then I ended up getting a partnership and wanting more, and like I said, it's just so easy. If you wanna support my Gunpla habit and maybe even start your own !! Gunpla. Okay. Well, that wasn't the worst. Could have been even more noticeable. Okay, I think it's pretty much done at this point. I do want to put the weapons on though, so let's see. Torso. Skirt. I call it a skirt, it's like his hips. Hips. 5 goes this wide. Click. 6 goes here. Arm 3 is here. 4 is here. Put his little head on. Look how good he looks! Wow! There you go. Oh, almost had it there for a second. Here, let's show you here. Look how cute! He's great! The little guy looks awesome! It's a boy! I don't know. He doesn't have... You know, some Gunpla have like... a protrusion? It looks like a hook. This one doesn't have it, so he doesn't have just an outright phallic hip protrusion. He has one of the mini nukes. Do you guys know what I'm talking about? Or am I just saying weird things now? Oh my god, I hope y'all understand what I mean. I forget which kits I've seen have it specifically, but it's so entertaining, clearly. To me, entertaining to me. I'm very easily entertained, I think. Okay, let's make the weapons, and then we'll finish her off. Him? Her? It? Ooh, compatible with the action base user. I want to give her the gun and the shield, so let's do the beam rifle D1. Oh, it's a very flat beam rifle, but that works. It's where they keep hitting gun. The Gunpla package. Oh yeah, you like my laugh, huh? It's always such a weird thing that I tend to laugh at. Oh. Thank you for the follow, Cleo Mike! How are you? Welcome to the stream. Caught us at a good time, we're finishing up. They did not make this to be cut off of. They really just want me to pop the part off. These are in bad spots. All right, well, fuck the god hand, right? Okay, if I want you to hold your beam rifle, you hold it in this hand. Hold it. Firmly grasp it. Oh god, his arm came off. Firmly grasp it. Oh no. No. Okay. B1 for the shield. Oh wait, actually D is empty, so trash. B1. And then this gate is also empty. Guys, we're almost done! We're almost done! Sticker 3. Oh, that's why it looks like this. I understand now. Okay, I have to hold this closer. You strong. Eight. Oh. Eight. It just keeps saying the same thing. Ooh, that's tricky. So here's another one of those tricky stickers. It's got perforations going almost completely to the center because it's going to be on this raised cross point here on the shield. And that's really cool, but also it makes the sticker really tricky. So that's why I can't do it under here, because I have to have it like up close. I can't see super great. And there's no undos or take backsies, as we saw. Just trying to flush out the beveling with the sticker. So cool. So tricky. Yeah, isn't it awesome, Jorge? George? Jorge? Sorry. Looks nice. Looks like you got it. Oh, thank you. Yeah, it looks super good, right? And yes, I love my nails so much. They make me so happy. They bring me so much joy. So good. Okay. Still another one. 12. And then that's the last sticker. Cool. This. Like this. There it is. So cool! Pew 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 pew. Okay, now what? Kit bash time! That's done. Gate A is done, except for this saber, beam saber. So we'll cut him out and save him for a later option. If I ever decide to change them, even though I never pose my Gunpla again, honestly. Like, I don't open these boxes again, so I don't know why I'm telling myself I might, but you never know! That's what happens when you're a collector, huh? Pew pew! Why does it say zero? Where does it say zero? Okay. So it's saying I'm gonna need these ones again. So we'll bring these out. Put away the gate holder. Separate out the boxes so I have one for the trash nubs and one for the parts that I'm keeping, like these gates and that saber. Paper cubes in here. The points command. Oh! Because we don't do anything with points here? I don't know. Stream Elements has an add-on for chats used for games and stuff. Yeah, I'm still trying to figure out how to do, like, giveaways and open and close giveaways and stuff like that, because I really, really want to do it. I just don't understand, and I haven't had the time, and I haven't put the time to figuring it out. Yeah, I've seen other streams use it, I just haven't figured it out for mine. Okay, let's see. Okay, so disassemble it. Says take off the head. So say goodbye, little guy. His head's gone. Gone. Put the head in the box. Okay, so we'll use this. Can you guys see the instructions? Here, let me move it. Boop! Like there! Great. I messed everything up. Awesome. And then, you pop the head off of Hello Kitty. body away. It says take off the bow. Put it away. Okay. Now we got C2 and C3. Were those the parts that... They were bigger parts. Where are they? Oh no, guys, did I do the thing where I lost something? Oh, they're right there. Phew! I really enjoy Hello Kitty. Me too! I know how to use some of it for the other channel I'm on, so we can use them. There's another one streamer likes to use follow age. Oh, see, yeah, there are like lots of different ways you can go about it and do things like that, but I haven't explored any of that yet, honestly. C3. Look how cool! Big ol' Hello Kitty Gunpla head, C3. You thought it was just a thing to show off how many points? I mean, maybe some people. It's not like your channel points. You guys remember when I used to play Fall Guys and I really wanted the Robo Kitty? Now I'm just making it. The Robo Kitty skin that I couldn't get because I think you either had to buy it or whatever. But I wasn't about to do that. Now I just make a Robo Kitty. Yes, group Fall Guys, you got your own now. Life works out, works itself out sometimes. I totally believe it. Trash gate. Such an accomplishment when you finish out a gate completely, I feel like. the only one left on this gate is B6. Put you in the save box. I'm in the rabbit hole and compiling more Gundam lore. Tell us about it, tokens. Go ahead. What else is interesting lore?
The new wave. Turn it up. I'm in the backseat chilling with your girl. What's up? She wanna talk all day, but I'm not in the mood. I'm trying to dance on.
Or actually, we might not have time today. I'm getting so close to finishing, I'm so excited. Oh wait, bring the bow back. The bow comes back. Bring the bow back, get rid of the apple. Okay, how's this go? This goes here. Whoa, so cool! And this one slides right in there. Wow, so cute! Okay. Now we do an additional head thing. A22. It does look amazing, right? I mentioned Cyber New Types for a split second there. You did, and I was like, what are those? Did anyone just get a notification for T-Pain? What? This goes on the back, and this should snap right on. Oh, you know what? I think I'm supposed to take this backpack off. Yeah, it told me to take the backpack off, I just forgot. Cause her head's too big. If I can get it off. There you go. A21. Is the last piece on the Hello Kitty gate. Hot dog. That's it. That's the end of the gates. Hello Kitty Gate, the scandal that hit us the hardest in 2020, who knew? The story with them is that people couldn't figure out how new types became new types, so they tried to make their own. They took normal people, brainwashed them, modified them to make them super soldiers, but sadly cyber new types are nowhere near as potent as the real one because of the process of making them extremely less mentally stable. They're prone to going insane and have to be kept in check with meds and stuff. Why did you say that they're the ones that are OP if they're still not as good? Okay, you put the helmet on the head. Whoa! Oh, damn! Look! So cool! So cute, so cool, what the heck? Consume! I don't know why I say consume, but it felt right. Consume this content, because this is premium. The last step. Oh, she good! Thank you for the biddies! It says, the last step says, united, as soon as you put the head, so. Shaken, you have to wait, watch this finale. United! Whoa! The neck looks kind of funny. Wow! Amazing! Look how cool! So cool. Ugh! I love it so much! 100% worth! And honestly, guys, this kit was pretty cheap. Like, reasonably, like, SD priced, you know, like, I can't remember if it was 12 or 24. I feel like it was probably closer to 24, but that's like really good. United! Thanks for hanging out, Shankin. I hope you have a good night. Get some rest. Sugoi dekai. What? Second gen cyber nucleotides are a little better. They're made through cloning and have modifications while still embryos. Okay, so they figured out how to make it better, but they're still technically not as good. Good night, Green. Yeah, we did it, guys. Hype. Oh, so worth. So amazing. Wow, I really enjoy like the details they put into it, cause like, yeah, it was like a lot more than just an SD, you know? Ugh. Look at her. So powerful. So cute. My little monster. 3-day work week, yo! That's awesome. This is a lot. Power stance activated. Hell yeah. You can't see, but it looks great. The cuteness to conquer nations. Our little monsters all grown up, ready to enslave humanity. This is great, guys. I'm so happy. Honestly, so fulfilling to finally finish something in one stream. I don't know why that was so hard for me, but we did it! Alright, guys. Well, I still have things I had to do tonight, but I'm really glad I was able to finish and share this moment with y'all because I've been dying to make this kit since it came in. So I really appreciate you guys. Thank you so much. I hope you have a wonderful holiday. May or may not see you on Thanksgiving. Join the Discord so you know what's up. I'll let y'all know if I'm gonna do stream my workout or whatever. But other than that, I will see y'all when I see y'all. Thank you, Draythian. Oh, whoa, it jumped a lot. Tokens working them keys. Thanks, Draythian. See you later, Cake Eater. John, yeah, isn't it awesome? Dirk Wonton. Good night. I imagine this is what it feels like to watch a kid go off to college. I know, right? It's so touching. Such a heartfelt moment. But sometimes they're all grown up. You remember when they were just Gates, fresh out of the box. And before you know it, they're ready to go to war. She's too cute. I'll see you later. Thank you so much, Tokens, for all the hard work. You're awesome. Thank you for helping me understand new types and breaking that down for me. Knives, have a great night. Firehawks, good night. Ludwig, Snorlax, Panda, night night. Tokens. Thank you guys. Bye.